and in consideration also of his claim for honest mistake, and of course, the apologies that he has given to this committee. And finally, in consideration, personal relations, as he has mentioned a while ago that he was my ninong, respectfully move, Mr. Chair, that the penalty be given be shortened to the barest minimum, which is just one day or 24 hours, Mr. Chair.
Second motion, Mr. Chair.
There is a motion, duly seconded. Congressman Ron Salo to cite Attorney Harry Roque in contempt is now approved.
I would like to move for reconsideration. It is not the severity of penalty, but the deprivation of liberty that I am appealing from. I believe that the right to liberty is amongst the most important of basic human rights, and there being no showing that there was an actual lying, but an honest mistake, and there was no actual disrespect, as evidenced by the fact that I have appeared 3 times out of the 4 invitations, I believe that any form of punishment by way of deprivation of liberty is unwarranted. Thank you, Mr.
Thank you,
Chair.
Attorney Harry Roque. Let it be of record that Attorney Harry Roque is asking for a reconsideration on the contempt orders that the committee has issued. So the next to interpolate is Congressman Ron Salo. You are recognized.
Thank you very much, Mr. Chair. Allow me, Mr. Chair, to propound some questions with the former Secretary Harry Roque. Secretary Roque, you deny to be a lawyer of Lucky South 99. I'm just wondering who are you trying to fool. We are not actually born yesterday, Secretary. Sa tingin mo po ba kaya mong paikutin ang mga tao sa hearing na ito kasama ang sambayan ng Pilipino? Of course, deny as much as you want. But the overwhelming pieces of evidence point to one thing. An only reasonable person, any reasonable person, will come to an unmistakable conclusion. You are part, or perhaps a lawyer, of Pogo South 99.
Mr. Chair, I resent that. I am not fooling anyone. I resent that also coming from someone who was my former law student and who was my inaanak. That's not the way to treat a resource person of this house. At least when I was a member of this house, we never treated resource persons in that way. I resent that for the record, Mr. Chairman.
May I ask the Honorable Member Kong Salo to refrain in issuing statements that would insult our resource persons. I am not saying you are, but try to avoid issuing statements that would hurt the feelings of our resource persons. Please proceed.
Will do, Mr. Chair. Mr. Chair, in our last hearing on August 16, Friday in Pampanga, Secretary Roque was invited by the Squad Committee. And Attorney Harry Roque sent a letter dated August 13, 2024, addressed to the Honorable Chairman Robert Ace Barbers. Are you the lead chairman? Informing Chair Barbers that he will not be able to participate in said meeting due to a conflict with the previously scheduled court hearing before the Regional Trial Court of Manila on 16 August 2024, the same date of our Quad Committee hearing. I have here a copy of that particular letter. Mr. Chair, we have also in receipt here a copy of certification from Attorney Jennifer H. De La Cruz Buendia, Clerk of Court and Ex-Officio Sheriff of Manila, RTC Manila, stating that Attorney Harry Roque has no hearing on August 16 and did not appear in the courts of Manila on said date. Mr. Chair, I hate to say it, but clearly, Attorney Harry Roque, our former secretary and my former professor, law professor, lied to this committee. And that amounts actually to disrespect on the members of the committee, which is contemptible under Section 11E. Of the rules of the House of Representatives on inquiries in aid of legislation. I therefore move, Mr. Chair, that Attorney Harry Roque be cited for contempt for disrespecting the members of this committee when he lied to evade in order to evade attending the hearing of this committee where he was invited. So move, Mr. Chair.
I did not quite hear what you said, Congressman Salo. Can you please repeat? Are you moving for the for the committee to cite Mr. Attorney Harry Roque in contempt?
Yes, Mr. Chair. Pursuant to Section 11E of the Rules of the House of Representatives in Aid of Legislation.
Mr. Chair?
One-minute suspension. Hearing is resumed.
Mr. Chairman.
Before I recognize you, Congressman Fernandez, allow the chair first to determine the parliamentary status. The parliamentary status is that there was a motion by Congressman Ron Salo to cite our resource person, Attorney Harry Roque, in contempt for lying before this committee when he was invited in August 16 when the Quadcom had its first public hearing. And according to that letter, he stated that he cannot attend for the reason that he has a hearing in an RTC in the city of Manila. Congressman Ron Salo read the certification issued by the clerk of court of the RTC Manila, which states that the hearing where Attorney Harry Roque is a counsel was scheduled in August 15 and not August 16. And in August 16, there was a certification from the same clerk of court saying that Harry Roque has no hearing in any of the RTC of the city of Manila. That is the parliamentary status, Your Honors, and there is a pending motion by Congressman Ron Salo to cite Attorney Harry Roque in contempt for lying before this committee when he submitted an excuse to his being absent in our hearing last August 16. Now, pursuant to our rules, Section 11 of the Rules of Procedure Governing Inquiries in Aid of Legislation, it says that the committee may punish any person for contempt by a vote of two-thirds of the members present, there being a quorum. The following shall be the grounds for citing any person in contempt. In this case, as stated by Congressman Salo, the reason for the contemptible act committed by our resource person is in paragraph E, which reads, acting in a disrespectful manner towards any member of the committee or any misbehavior in the presence of the committee. So, may I solicit comments from our members before we rule on this motion? In the spirit of fairness, because the committee has been citing our resource persons who have violated this rule in contempt and detaining them in the premises of the House of Representatives. Would there be any comment from our members?
Mr. Chair, before we vote,
Chairman Labonte,
before we vote of the contempt, we would like to hear first the explanation of the reason behind his absence to this committee last year.
Thank you, Your Honor. I was hoping to be given an opportunity to be heard. It was an honest mistake, Your Honor. I have also been a member of this chamber. We don't hold hearings on Fridays. So when I saw the notice of hearing, I assumed that just like the first and the second hearing where I attended, that it would be on a Thursday. And that is true, that I had a hearing both in the morning and in the afternoon. And that is why I sent that letter. By the time I realized that it was a Friday and there was in fact a hearing, it was also close already to lunchtime and the hearing was in Pampanga. So I apologize for the honest mistake, but the truth of the matter is, I have been here on Thursday, so two hearings already, and I just assumed that just like in the past, where we don't hold hearings on a Friday, that the hearing would be on a Thursday, as in fact, today is also a Thursday. So it was an instance of, okay, there's a hearing, it's on Thursday again, and I have a hearing on Thursday, that's why I sent the letter right away, not even realizing that 16 is a Friday. That was an honest mistake. Had I had any intentions not to appear, I would not have appeared today as well. But in the first two instances, and those were the two instances where I was invited, I in fact appeared. I have no wish to disrespect the very same body of which I was a part of, which I consider at some point in time as my happy place, in fact, the House of Representatives. Thank you, Your Honors.
Any other member who wish to make a comment?
Mr. Chairman, can we have
Congressman
a copy,
Fernandez?
Can we have a copy of that certification that was issued by the Regional Trial Court? Because I haven't seen the copy yet. And that's the reason why medyo kanina I was a bit shocked about it. So,
here. So while Congressman Fernandez is still reading the certification,
Mr. Chair, I'd like to ask Secretary Roque, what is the reason for your apology?
Well, it was really an honest mistake, Your Honor.
So you're apologizing not for your absence, but for an honest mistake?
It was an honest mistake, Your Honor, because I've been here every Thursday. And as a former member of this chamber, as a former employee of this chamber, I know that in the regular course of business, we don't really have hearings on Fridays. In fact, even if you call the trunk line of the House of Representatives on a Friday, no one will answer. That has always been the policy, no? So when I saw the notice of hearing, I really thought it was also on a Thursday, like the first two hearings where I attended. That is why I apologize for the honest mistake.
Mr. Chair.
Congressman Akop, and then Congressman Paduano, and then Congressman Fernandez. Congressman Akop, you're recognized.
Thank you, Mr. Chair. Attorney Roque, nag-assume po kayo na mali, di po ba?
Nagkamali po.
Kaya nga, yung assumption nyo mali.
Opo, mali nga po yun.
And therefore, pag nag-assume ka ng mali, you should be ready for the consequences. Hindi ba dapat ganun?
Yes po, but there was no intent to disrespect this chamber.
I'm not asking whether you have the intent. Ang tinatanong ko lang po doon is, kung nag-assume po kayo ng mali, hindi po ba dapat tanggapin ninyo yung consequences?
I will of course accept the consequences, the decision of this body, but since I was given an opportunity to be heard, I thought that there should be allowance for honest mistakes.
Kasi, pagpasensya mo na ako. Kasi ako, I know that you have been practicing as a lawyer for a long time. Di po ba?
Yes, Your Honor.
And as a practicing lawyer, lahat po ng schedule ninyo nakalagay. For example, for the week, kung ano ang hearing mo for the week, ano yung appointment mo, nakalagay po. Di po ba?
Totoo po yun. Kaya nga po, dun sa certificate, talagang may hearing po ako nung Thursday. And mali nga lang po yung assumption ko na yung sumunod na hearing ay hindi na pala Thursday dahil puro Thursday po tayo.
Ang ibig nyo pong sabihin, wala sa schedule ninyo yung dapat umattend kayo ng hearing sa Friday, nung Friday?
Yun nga po, nailagay ko po siya nung Thursday kasi every Thursday po yung hearing natin.
Then, as it is, kayo po lahat ang may kasalanan. Wala.
Opo, pero wala
naman. Participation ng iba.
Opo, pero wala naman pong intention to disrespect the chamber.
Hindi ko po kine-question yung intention nyo. Ang kine-question ko lang, as a practicing lawyer, ang alam ko, yung mga lawyers, meron silang sinusulatan lahat ng kanilang mga schedule. In your case, kung nakalagay yung schedule na yun dun sa yung event na yun sa yung book of schedules, dapat alam ninyo.
Sa totoo nga lang po, dahil akala ko Thursday, nakita ko na morning afternoon ng hearing ko, sumulat na ako kaagad to inform the committee as soon as possible dahil ang buong akala ko po talaga Thursday.
Attorney Roque, marami na pong namatay dahil sa maling akala. Kindly bear that in mind. Thank you, Mr. Chair.
Thank you, Congressman Acop. Congressman Paduano, you're recognized.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. Anyway, tama po yung sinabi ni Chairman Acop na that's your fault and you should face the consequences, di ba? Now, eto lang po. Kaya ako, of course, the intent, hindi pwede natin pag-usapan dito yung intent. Kasi, the question is, ito, well, in fact, you're calling the chairman of this committee. Well, in fact, you text me with regards to your request for your wife to be excused in today's hearing. Now, as you mentioned, nalaman mo na after lunch, nag-hearing sa Pampanga. Di ba? At the very least, man lang, sana you texted me, you call me, or you call the chairman na hindi po ako makarating dyan kasi nagkamali ako. But you never do it. Kaya yung question of intent, sabi ko nga, hindi pwede magiging basis for that possible contempt, no? Na minove ni Congressman Ronzalo. Kaya ako, ang ano ko lang dito is, supposedly, at the very least, again, you have texted or called us, if not me, you called Chairman Abante, well, in fact, on that request, you called Chairman Barbers, but you never do it. So, ako, Mr. Chairman, I join the motion of the first motion of Congressman Salo. Thank you, Mr. Chairman.
Thank you, Congressman Paduano. Congressman Salo.
Thank you very much, Mr. Chair. Mr. Chair, and to this honorable committee, in consideration of the fact that the resource person, former Secretary Harry Roque, is my former law professor, fellow Kabayan Party List representative, and a former member of this House of Representatives, and in consideration also of his claim for honest mistake, and of course, the apologies that he has given to this committee, and finally, in consideration personal relations, as he has mentioned a while ago that he was my ninong, respectfully move, Mr. Chair, that the penalty be given be shortened to the barest minimum, which is just one day or 24 hours, Mr. Chair.
Second motion, Mr. Chair.
There is a motion, duly seconded, to impose a penalty of 24 hours to our resource person, Attorney Harry Roque. Hearing no objection, the motion is carried. One minute
Chair.
Suspension. The ruling has been made on the contempt order of this committee to our resource person, Attorney Harry Roque, and imposing a penalty of 24 hours detention in the detention facility of the House of Representatives. So after the committee hearing, may we ask Attorney Harry Roque to at the LSB or the SA, the Sergeant, the Office of the Sergeant at Arms, to assist Attorney Harry Roque to his detention center.
Thank you.
Congressman Abante, are you going to ask questions?
Yes,
related to
connected to the personalities that were invited here.
Okay,
sayang
please proceed.
Naman, kung halimbawa, hindi nila matanong yan. So I'd like to ask a question here.
Okay. The resource person, Attorney Harry Roque, wishes to be recognized.
Yes.
I will give you, Attorney Harry Roque, 2 minutes to make your manifestation.
Thank you, Mr. Chair. I would like to move for reconsideration. It is not the severity of penalty, but that the deprivation of liberty that I am appealing from. I believe that the right to liberty is amongst the most important of basic human rights. And there being no showing that there was an actual lying but an honest mistake, and there was no actual disrespect as evidenced by the fact that I have appeared 3 times out of the 4 invitations, I believe that any form of punishment by way of deprivation of liberty is unwarranted. Thank you, Mr. Chairman.
Thank you, Attorney Harry Roque. Let it be of record that Attorney Harry Roque is asking for a reconsideration on the contempt orders that the committee has issued. Under our rules, there must be, again, another vote on this. And since there is no motion to vote, we will have to wait for the time that when we resume in our next hearing, we will probably consider the reconsideration, motion for reconsideration of Attorney Harry Roque.